Hello, Yorkies. Welcome to the second season of What You Missed in Sports. I'm Alex Cole. For those who couldn't join us last year, What You Missed in Sports is a weekly sports recap series that goes over scores and updates of our York Lions over the past week. We'll also be noting the top performers of the week at the end of the show, so stick around to catch the best of the best. Typically, Matt will be with me, but he won't be here today. He will be here next week. So, without further ado, let's get right into it by starting off with our York Lion football team, who pounded our crosstown rivals, the U of T Varsity Blues, by a score of 41-16 to win the annual Red and Blue Bowl. The game was all York the entire way, as the Lions managed to score 3 touchdowns in the first half against the Blues, the most notable one being a 10-yard fumble recovery for a touchdown after an earth-shattering sack by the Lions' defense. U of T did manage to fight back in the second half with a pair of touchdowns, but it was not enough to secure the victory, as York pounded U of T with unrelenting pass protection throughout the entire game. The performance marks the first victory against the Blues in 5 years and was led by the play of quarterback Brent Hunchak, who went 19 for 27 with 253 passing yards and 3 touchdowns. Running back Adam Adebowoye also had a stellar game, rushing for 140 yards and scoring 2 touchdowns. For their next game, the Lions will be traveling to Hamilton on September 30 to face off against the McMaster Marauders. Kickoff is at 1 p.m. Now, on to our men's soccer team. The Lions had an impressive week, defeating the 5th-ranked Guelph Griffins by a score of 1-0, as well as the Waterloo Warriors by a score of 4-0. The Guelph game was a competitive matchup, with both teams failing to score in the first half hour of the match. The lone goal came in the 35th minute, when midfielder Christian Cavallini netted his 6th goal of the season. This would prove to be the game winner. The second matchup against the Warriors was a chance for the Lions to correct their offensive miscues, and they succeeded right out of the gate by scoring 3 scores in the first 22 minutes. It was in the 59th minute when Christian Cavallini netted his 3rd goal of the game, bringing the score to 4-0, which would be the final. A special kudos also goes to goaltender Mike Argaraz, who completed his 5th clean sheet of the season. The Lions are now tied for 2nd in their division with a record of 7-2. The women had a couple of matchups this week too, falling to the Griffins by a score of 2-0 in Guelph, and tying their matchup against the Waterloo Warriors 1-1 in Waterloo. The Lions had no answer for the mighty Griffins, who capitalized on York's early mistakes to make the score 1-0 off of a miscommunication in the Lions' zone. Guelph put the game to bed in the 70th minute by scoring another goal courtesy of Griffin Victoria Hinchcliffe. This would prove to be the final score of the matchup. The women's second matchup was an improvement on the first, as they managed to split the decision against the Waterloo Warriors 1-1. Lone York goal comes courtesy of Christina Morelli, who managed to net her 2nd of the season in the 48th minute. However, with a Warrior goal 8 minutes later off the foot of Ainsley Seedorf, the match ended in a stalemate between the two clubs. This week's matchups for the two Lions clubs will find them back home on Alumni Field, as the Lions will be facing off against Waterloo for the 2nd game of a 2-game series, as well as the Western Mustangs. For the women, kickoff is at 1 p.m. for both games, and for the men, kickoff is at 3:15 for both games. Finally, we find our way to field hockey, where the Lions were pitted up against 3 teams in a Kingston meetup last week. The results couldn't have gotten any better, as the ladies swept the competition, defeating U of T by a score of 3-0, McGill by a score of 6-1, and Guelph by a score of 3-1. The top performer of the series easily goes to Jazzland Sterling, who scored an incredible 6 goals in the 3-game span. The victories bring the Lions to an OUA best 5 wins and 0 losses on the season. Their next matchup will be on October 1st, where the Lions will be pinned up against U of T and Queens in the Blues' home field. Good luck out there, Lions. The top performers of the week was not a difficult decision to make, as these players gave it their all in the matchups this week. The top performers are none other than Jazzland Sterling for her 6 goal performance for the Lion field hockey team, Christian Cavallini for his hat trick against Waterloo, and Adam Adebowoye for his 140-yard rushing game with 2 touchdowns. And that's all for this week, folks. Stay tuned next week for more Lions news, scores, and updates.